Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Paul's here, and tonight we are doing my F1 2017 at Career Mode. We're on part 75, season 4, round 15 in Malaysia. I am doing 100% race for the first ever fucking time. Oh boy. Qualifying was a disaster. I'll explain in a minute.
Hello. I just wanted to pass on the team's expectations for this race. Good luck.
10th. Yeah, you'll see why in a bit. Right. Q1, top. Practice 2, 3, top. Practice 1, second. Qualifying 2, 15th, because I changed my components out at the end of qualifying 1 and forgot that it ruins and runs the whole time down. So, yeah. Slightly further down the grid than I wanted to be. But we are here tonight. As you'll see, 15th I qualify. We've already changed our components ready. So this is going to be straight into the race. Now, folks, I want to drive for Mercedes or Ferrari. It's either next season, this season coming, obviously the next one, or the one after. We're in 717th, and of course, as you see, we did manage to scrape a very, very hard-earned 10th place, but this now is entering unknown territory, 100% race. We have an R&D nearly available. We need 170 points for the tyre wear. We're not going to be able to do it this race, of course. We'll be able to do it next Grand Prix, and then, of course, we're just going to, as I said, we're going to save up for the whole of the tyre wear lot. And just keep going and going and going on that front. But this basically is where we're at, I guess. I could get that one. No, I'm not going to bother, fuck it. We'll be fine, we'll be fine. So what we're going to do is we're going now. We're going to wait for Twitch to load up, unfortunately. We're just putting a bit of a delay on the Twitch again here. Do you know what? While that's loading, we're going to go. Malaysian Grand Prix, 100%. Here we go. I was working on. Refresh. And it's raining.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. Valtteri Bottas lines up on pole position.
Pole.
And Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have
Raikkonen,
Ricciardo, Max Verstappen, and Perez.
Did he go out as well? I can't remember.
Grosjean, Massa, and Carlos Sainz. Palmer, Alonso, Nico Hülkenberg, and a Force India. Stroll,
so
Ericsson,
14th,
Kevin Magnussen, and Sebastian Vettel.
Behind me.
Van Dorn and Pascal Wehrlein completes the grid.
Very
and
interesting.
Now
this.
It's time to head down to the track.
So we are here. We're going for the long haul tonight, folks. I'm going to just crank up to the full amount of fuel, 105 kilos. And here we go. Start towards the front and end up going back. Alonso's beat me again. This is going to be one for the ages, my first 100% Grand Prix on F1 2017. The 15s were okay, I wanted to try something new, I wanted strategy, and all of a sudden, we're lumped with a full wet race. Intense. In fact, I'm actually going to take my coat off. It's not that cold anymore. Five views already, guys. This is My first ever 100%, so fuck knows how this is gonna go. Probably bad. That's right, at this point, we had 3 wing changes, still coming 5th. I'm 7th, so I can't. Van Dorn got 5th. And Berlang got a podium. Anything is possible. These conditions, we haven't really, really any heat into these tyres at all. Folks, this is going to be huge. No restarts. I hope to God all you guys are settled in, buckle up tight. Over 3,400 views. Absolute bunch of sexy bastards. Kevin Magnussen down there again, so we beat Magnussen, funnily enough. Red lights. 10th this race. We can deliver 5 lights. We're off the Malaysian Grand Prix. This is going to be bloody brilliant, isn't it? Let's get all the way across the track, which is probably just really just inside Palma. So as well, actually, the points already, which is to be very cautious. So that's not gonna stick. No one else does. Oh, we lose it where no one else does. Suddenly I think he's gonna get it. Yeah, he's gonna settle in. Oh my god. Do it, Palmer. I've done that. Attempt to move. Really settle in here, don't we? Subscribers we have on the channel, which is rather tasty at this stage of my pitch career. This position's took off, I think it's Bottas took off up front. We need to make this a top 7 rather than a top 6 and me, don't we? Yet still holding that 8th position. Seb coming through a bit later in the race as well. Settling in very well here. Maybe at least one sick break for me. Maybe 2. Thank you. themselves in this Grand Prix. Thank you. Mercedes. Both Mercedes are on the front row, I believe. But one in fourth, the other one is shooting in second. Conventional line around that. Should be nice now, just to chill in the state class of the race. Just racing up to the second half of the top 10. So just hit our teammate. I'm so sorry, Sergio. I didn't even need to outbrake myself there. We are up in a set place, so we're beating our teammate now. That's our first goal, our second goal completed in this race. Thank you. I have retirements. Singapore at 50%, it's gone. Malaysia at 100. Still go out ahead of last, so that is the rule. Of course, it will. Don't have to pit though. Four percent pit lap. That's not bad. That's what I'd have. I'd happily take that. Stopped at a go at Hamilton here, but that's going to compromise his line. Didn't impact on the apex very soundly. So Hamilton should streak away from Verstappen now. Should. Theory, anyway. Dreadfully wide. To play inside. Missed out his career mode. Since McLaren, I've been overtaken by a car. Oh, fantastic. Sit there, I'm going to try and get it back here. Great battle with Danny Rick so far, back up in the fifth position. I'm going to help Perez. Max Verstappen, are we going to be able to? will be able to. It's just a case of when rather than if, isn't it now? Late on the brakes, early on the power, up in a fourth place, beautiful move. It's time not to chase down Lewis, isn't it? It's a key move there, overtaking Verstappen. Especially forcing this Constructors' Championship, this is absolutely vital. We're now on the same points as Red Bull from this Grand Prix. Sky is the limit. Red Bull, of course, have got really, really good downforce. Aerodynamically, possibly the best car on the field. It's come out, and it is. It's Hamilton. Hamilton's gone. Hamilton pulls off. Huge moment in the Grand Prix. God, I'm spinning off myself. Jesus Christ. Lewis Hamilton is out of the Grand Prix. Lap 8. We know, we're behind him. Huge upset. Knocks us out a little bit, doesn't it? VSC when we fuck up. Carter's all over the back of Verstappen here. So now means we have more points than the Red Bull in the constructive battle here by one. We're amazing. If we pit now, we come out in the top 10. This is such a good race. This is such a good car. Singapore is a dog in the end, but we managed to force the result almost. Copious amounts of restarts. The thing I'm concerned about is we're not pulling away from the Red Bulls, which we hopefully will soon. Didn't know about this until we got to qualifying, of course, that we had a wet race. I'm sorry, Scott, I've not got the ability to look at the comments just yet. I'll have a check in a minute for you. So we're half a second close to Perez and we got to Bottas up front. That's not what I want. I want to be close to Bottas now. Perez hopefully will find himself fourth coming pit stops and hopefully find himself in a comfortable position ahead. We've already got two cars pitting in already at this early stage of the Grand Prix. We get into motor now, finally. So I've never failed to score in Malaysia. We're now smack bang in the podium position, which is where I firmly want to be, of course. That's where I'm aiming to be. would easily haul Vettel in. He's nowhere to be seen at the moment. I don't think, anyway. No, he's Kvyat still on that trailer. Look at this. Insanity here. Lewis is out, which means that's not stopping us. We have a chance for the lead. Kimi Raikkonen can do something like that. Just got me. There's a car off the track. That is, it's going slow. Move on. Who they are, I think the guys at the back of the field. There's a couple of the puncture at the back, I don't know who that is. It's hard to pit it. If it's Vettel, then it's over for him. Nothing's over, but you know what I mean. Path of the finishing position, anyway. Oh, almost lost sight of the cars behind us. Anybody new to the stream, guys, please follow. This is my first ever 100% race on this game, by the way. First one for almost a year. Well, a good 6 months at least, anyway. It's the ESR Saturday recently, and that didn't go too well, so I've been a bit sceptical about the chances. It's good at surviving the races. Shot it. Race overheated. It's Renault. Probably Hülkenberg. He's had punctured retirements every race since Canada, I think it is. Absolutely, so far I feel that we're stupid. We already are. It was weird battling out the front rather than the back. In Malaysia, I've always been sort of mid-pack in McLaren, so you expect a lot more from me in the Force India, wouldn't you, really? But another track that I'm very fond of. Obviously, we're going to go to Suzuka next time. I do 100% around there, and it's one of my least favourite tracks in the fucking world. Higgins not doing these guys behind any favours. He needs to help Perez out here, preferably. Yellow flag, and that, I believe, is Hülkenberg off the track. We'll have a look at that on instant replay. Oh, Verstappen hit him. Ricardo hit him, sorry. Valtteri here. This ironically is the same finishing lineup in Abu Dhabi season 3, when I went to this podium. Double figure views, guys, thank you so much. We're going to have this time get this move done right. Cover the inside this time. Very neat move, and we now are on our fucking hot high horse, hot tail, whatever the fuck you want to call it, after Raikkonen. See what we can do. What different pink car can do. 11.7. Okay, let's see what we're up to. Anybody new to the stream, guys, please be sure to drop a follow. It really does benefit me to get the views that we need. And make sure as well you head over to the YouTube channel, check out all my other content. So close to nearly hitting that 5,000 view mark on YouTube. It's got so little followers, actually, with the view count, but it shows that people are loyal and sticking around. Well, not subscribing because they're annoyed by me. Anyway, probably a bit enough. Right, here we go. So we're on the back of the same gap apart. That's rather annoying. That's a way to answer back. That's a key way to answer back there. Smash out 1 minute 51.1 in intermediate conditions for Malaysia. On semi-worn tyres too. One goal for me. Let's get the race win in Malaysia, which means I'll have gone win, shit, win, shit, win, which means I've gone to Super, which is guaranteed to be shit. I've been out the points since Austria. Hell of a lap here. Hopefully we can do this at absolute perfection. Absolute perfection, sorry, get my grammar right. Whew, I'm coming to quarter distance. For me. He hasn't done it yet on screen. Very eagle-eyed in that case. I'm going to pit in now. This guy's all going to be on warm rubber. I'm going to be on fucking brand new fresh rubber. This is heavy rain, 10 to 15 minutes. In 15 minutes, I did say, sorry, forgive me. Who's that? The car off there? That's a big pile-up! Take a look on the replay. I'm guessing it has something to do with Mr. Hulkenberg again. Is that... I believe that's... Was that Magnussen? Is that Rojan? was it Grosjean? And the two of them spun. Oh, and the Williams stick the Haas. This Vettel. Oh my god, poor Hulkenberg, he's been everywhere. Maybe a safety car coming up here. Hulkenberg stranded on the infield. Let's check out the race director. I don't think there's been much going on with Hulkenberg whamming into a few cars. Yep, speeding under virtual city, got Hulkenberg and Palmer. That's why they both went in, and then Hulkenberg collided. It was Palmer at the back. It was Palmer at the back. Vettel's already up to ninth. Palmer actually did have a pit stop. He was the one at the back, and he's been the one causing the problems. Hulkenberg has already overtaken Van Dorn. So we currently sit in second position with an early pit stop based on the weather. I'll be back in 2 minutes, guys. Thank you so much. Hopefully stick around. And we're back. So we are a quarter of the way through the race. Let's go. Turning out comfortably in sixth position. Bit of my start in the pack. Let's try to put that first corner right. Luckily 15th place at the start. We've got Aston 7th now, so he's going to be coming out quite quick. For the moment. I'm going to lean a little bit later in the Grand Prix. I don't think I'll get to the end on this fuel stand-up mix at least, so I'm going to have to bring lean a little bit. A little bit later. I get a bit of that to the best part. Shame if these guys go to lap 29, not really. I'm classifying myself in 6th at the moment, this is our actual position. It's a 2nd, and Perez needs to clear Daniel Ricciardo very soon. Bottas hasn't escaped the Red Bull, but Bottas is falling back, clutches essentially the understaffing here. Ricciardo is just holding Perez up. Absolutely fucking flying. All the red lap folks, we are careering around this track. Not on Raikkonen's level yet, I think Raikkonen almost pit right in front of Ricciardo. It's all going to be down to the heavy rain conditions, how we can cope with that. Thank you. stunning last sector again. 6.5 seconds behind now. 1 point. I think that's about 3 seconds again on that lap on Perez. Perez is round the corner now, as is Ricciardo. We need Perez fourth. Fifth it'll be, of course. Straight away from the back markers, so we're going to be lapping lots of cars in this race. Hopefully you guys are enjoying the show so far. Really putting on a clinic in terms of this car's ceiling. Hasn't got 3% tyre wear per lap, that is unbelievable. This car is going to 22 laps. So, not a problem, should have hit on 14, it was like. So, we're actually going to be buffering, which I was. There is Sergio. Was running in power with Max Verstappen in 2016. Went for a slower team, okay, getting the odd point, and then moving to Red Bull and winning his first Grand Prix. And it's something very, very similar, of course. Remember the, I think it was left out of the dust. Two-stop Bottas, of course. is this? Can't we just slide on the Sergio? It's on the undercar, that's fantastic. Sergio, it's side by side here. I'm on the wrong side of the track, I'm not going to be going through any moves. He's come up right in front of us here. Raikkonen has excellent pits. He's just done enough to keep in front of me, but now we have him right in our sights. He actually disposed of Perez in a fucking fantastic manoeuvre. We have the Wraith back. If anyone wants to grab a clip of that for me, guys, please do. It's a 7 points of ours will be happening. Oh boy. It's not always the battle for the lead. Perez needs to pit in this lap. This very lap. It's a double slam. Okay, we'll probably pull in briefly. Henrik is out, not really overly arsed, but... position here. I've actually had a second place, so just to get one. I want to realistically win this Grand Prix. I don't know how I'm going to do it. Yeah, Raikkonen did just about get me. Yeah, Corey, I'm switching it up, mate. Some more of a challenge. Proved to be a good decision so far. I think that is that Ricciardo in the pits? Over for Verstappen. Verstappen made a bit of movie there. Perez comes in too. Just up for you. We've got 9 seconds on that pit stop though, so anything can happen, of course. Next cigarette break will be coming on the next pit. So, forward, a couple of minute breaks, or get yourself a refreshment, or V up. Whatever it is you want to do. See any problems on these tyres? I get comfortably quicker than me. What am I actually going to do? I'm going to keep going on the standard mix. When it goes up to full, that's going to save some fuel, I think. Morales a nice cheeky win here. If I can't, that second position has been sensational. Still all good to go. The only retirement so far is on Lewis Hamilton from third place, of course. To lap our second car. Palmer had a puncture earlier on the race. I'll look at that coming in a second, Corey, forgive me. Stop of the race, 496. That's been my fastest lap. I think it was like an old lap to go, so I'm not really caught right going on that much. Slightly conscious of this saddle going front. It's going to lead to me catching an heavy rain's coming in a minute now. Unless they tell me to change. There's another car in trouble. I don't know who that is. There's a car off again. It may be beat. And Palmer again, sorry. Wicker's been hit. Wicker's lost some wing. Wicker's lost a bit of wing here. I'm going to take a sacrifice if Ericsson is driven into the side. Kimi Raikkonen. Wicker's going to have wing damage. That is definite wing damage. Saw the car debris fly off. It was the Sauber's wing, I'm assuming, then. Debris did fly off, and Raikkonen did spin, or half spin. Really giving us a chance here. Can Raikkonen really be okay here? We've really pulled the gap in. Really struggling. This could be huge. We are quicker. I'm going to think we're going to make a move here. Comfortably into the lead of the Malaysian Grand Prix with a bit of luck. Luck is on our side, it seems, in this Grand Prix so far. I'm not going to go in. Thursday night victory in RRL, of course, driving this track. Me and RRL addict had a hell of a battle. I was in a Ripple, he was in a, I think it was a Haas or something. So you can kind of understand why that, how that went down. No, I wasn't. I was in a Mercedes, he was in the Rebel. I'm sure it was something like that. Raikkonen is just ruined in this Grand Prix now. As much time on Perez in, I believe it's 10 in 7 or 8 laps, so 4 or 5 laps, so we haven't liked it in 1, you know what I mean? So he's struggling. He's killing him. Will they change it? I don't know. Carlos Sainz here to complete his 16th position. Approaching half distance, of course, next cigarette break must be coming out, my next pit stop. Still that Raikkonen, we're going to go for an execution maneuver. That's it for him, all he wants, I don't really care. He's going to end up being quicker than Kimi Raikkonen, which isn't hard. super slalom on. Wait for the... Well, I'm almost going to say the future champion, even in this car. Have to be quicker. It's heavy rain conditions this now. Sainz is hauling in Wehrlein. I'm not beckoned in. The car's handling absolutely fine. Plates on my side at the moment, so I'm going to keep driving until the tyres don't feel right. Pit for whatever they want to put me on. There's 10 laps of this tyres yet, so we'll we've got a car struggling here. It's a blue flag car, and there's a car sailing off the track. Oh my god, what is going on back there? Who is that? It is, I believe, Red Bull. Oh, he's lost his wing. Oh, is it the other Red Bull? Oh, my days. I think he's out of the race. Oh my god, he's out! Daniel Ricciardo DNF! Because of Stoffel Van Dorn! Who also DNFs? No. No. We do not need this. Both cars retire. And the other Red Bull's lost his wing. Perez is up and forth. Comfortably. Get in there! It's been cleared. I haven't had confirmation of who's got out on the main monitor yet, which is curious. Scenario. What's in your first and fourth as it stands? Raikkonen with a wing, with wing damage too. This is looking very delightful. People start thinking I'm out of creating my own results here, Jesus Christ. Fixing grids on my driver. I can just fall back into the clutches of Valtteri here, which is very intriguing. can stop ahead of Raikkonen at this current, at this rate. One way to go to our pit stops, and we are just absolutely fucking nailing this Grand Prix. A lot of luck has fell our way. Hamilton retired early. Raikkonen had an incident with Marcus Ericsson. Could have been us, of course. Ericsson with him. He's in on 15th place to lap. Sergio Perez comfortably fourth as well. This is turning into a dream scenario. Just over half distance now. I'm not even gonna core if I want him. Wow, we are absolutely fucking beasting, baby. You know what, while I'm doing this, I'm gonna lean mix it actually. Get some fuel back in the car. I've got a car off again. Who is that? I think it's Julian Palmer, and he's coming right back into the vicinity in front of Kimi Raikkonen here. And that's gonna cause problems again. Just absolutely having a mare in this in the second phase of this race. The second stint. Yeah, I believe. He's falling 3.5 seconds down again here. I'm gonna leave it, so I'm just gonna chill. No point risking anything here, just put my feet up to the end of the race, I guess. Let me catch me. Countless incidents. Anybody who is new to the stream, please be sure to drop me a follow. 100 AI difficulty, of course, you guess what I'm running. And we have 20 laps to go, and we are following our rival. It's our old rival, Roman Grosjean, who was involved in the Palmer incident, ironically, earlier in the race. Leave it, we are absolutely smashing it. Tapped down in lead. Attempted to throw a set of inters back on, you know, I don't really see the point in going for that just yet. See what they do. Shift your fucking ass out of my way. This is not how you get out of the race in this way, Roman. Paid the price, I'm going to stop on track there. The Raikkonen's car's got square wheels, so, you know, it kind of helps us out a little bit. It's fourth. This is an amazingly turned out race for us. We were literally stuck in 15th place. It's the fourth, so I got 14th. I'm going to that by Roman. We are going to be the hunted later, but Valtteri Bottas finally displaces Kimi Raikkonen, who's on the fucking most recent season so far, as we said. Season 5 guys are going to be dropping 105% AI as well. I think what I might do in season 6 to do the championship actually. If I can't, then I'll just stop it teaching one at a time. So I'm just driving stupidly well here. Kimi is now pit stop behind me. I can come in now. So Vince is going to come out second. Yeah, I can. Second place. Off again. It's another collision. Love of God, there's going to be penalties on that everywhere in this race. Hülkenberg is smashing this. But look at this, Stroll over going Massa. Switch back on a senior teammate. Gonna have to pit. I should pit last lap. Look at this fucking traffic. Let's move on the outside. I'll be on the grass. It shouldn't be too much of a problem. I pit in here, guys. I think probably this lap. Maybe next lap. Jeffrey, you sexy bastard. Everything is working. Everything is working here. Everything has worked. Right into place. Oh, okay. Hamilton went out very early on. Ricardo and Van Dorn went out recently, actually. Palmer is just fucked in this Grand Prix. Verstappen has pitted twice. He's behind Vettel. That's curious. Me and Vettel have both made a combined place total of 20. 30 even, sorry. Actually, no, sorry. It's 27. 26, forgive me. Kvyat driving a really good race here. Next car on the track would have been Kevin Magnussen. Guys, I'm just going to go for a quick cigarette. I'll be back with you for the conclusion of the Malaysian Grand Prix. Back in two. seen your thing there, Corey. Lucky there, buddy. Finally seen the comments. You can tell how concentrated I am in this Grand Prix. Come on. Go, go, go. Why the hell is that long? Problem at all. It's Kimmy. That's the only real problem we have. Kimmy going back to the field after a fucking change, of course. It's now Kimmy, so we've got ourselves a bit of an advantage, everyone. Sadly, Kimi is just destroyed in this Grand Prix, by the way. Anything can happen, of course. We've still got 19 laps to go, so... Who is that off the track again? Mark will still come to the Grimmel Bottas, so this is us till the end. Wing change, even if we have got to go for a wing change, I have confidence in my ability to pull myself back up in this order. The man is just absolutely hold on, so let's chill kind of. It's a silly place to let me through, but let's be there anyway. Rival. Martin hits Twitter feed. Three, we have slow sector. Oh, I think this is us to the end now. Maybe catch. It's in position, Massa. This is not 7th, it's 7th. QBR. QBR, really good set race here. Intriguing. 2 laps ago, he hit Ericsson. It's been Ericsson off the track. Falling into the clusters of Perez, surely to God, Raikkonen is really struggling. Perez is going to be overtaken by Verstappen and Vettel. I don't mind Perez going to save. Perez going to save is good. Getting catch of it, right? It's staying from Verstappen. Chill. Chill out race to speed. It's really, really fresh. just not liking this collision. Oh, the axle hit by the other Ferrari. Okay, better. Just enough to endure this one got over here. Best car all weekend, really. My stupid is it? Oh, I still have 14 on the grid. This is one of the lowest ever grid positions to win a race. It ties Michael Schumacher. Maybe John Watson, like an 82. But scary, however, so well in the first half. Imagine if I was in a fucking McLaren. If I wasn't in McLaren for the first half of the season, I'd be winning the championship by a year. I'm going to probably move at the end of season 5, but I will leave as a champion. That's all I'm saying. I will not leave this car until it wins a championship. No way. Perez, I believe, is escaping. Nearly 50 seconds clear of third. This has been an app. This reminds me of Kimi's performance in China. In one for each channel, barring season 3, on the lap day, the entire lap would be all good. So I finished like a lap and a half down in the points. It was the season, actually. Somebody won. Four laps down. pace of this car is just fucked, right? He's already got blue flags. I believe I'm just carrying on, but I just retire and see if the car can do it. Ready? Wipe me out of the fucking fixed lap, actually, as well, if you remember. I was side by side with Palmer on sector 2 on lap 1. Amazing feat, we just managed to hold on. Imagine if we didn't have an intimate with Palmer. Like half the field have. This has escaped. Perez's car is working again. That is a dream-like scenario, baby. It's 12 and a half laps to go. We're just walking it. This second half of these last five races have really made up. The 70 before, I've had to absolutely push for it. It's the limit to get where I've got. This goes to show what would happen if I'd accepted somewhere like a Haas or a Renault or maybe Williams, where I would have been. I wouldn't have wanted to leave Williams, that's the problem. Check the weather. So heavy rain until the end. Vettel can just stay ahead of Verstappen. And will be overtaking Verstappen, I believe, at the end of this race. And we can then focus on catching our teammate, whoever's in front of us. Right now, this is just obliteration. Beyond obliteration here. Fourth lap of 56, and it's been really, 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 really fun. Catch Kimi out now. The car's out! Who is it? Grosjean is out. So we're down to 16 cars. 16 runners here. Safety car will just mean a pit, basically. It's a dangerous place to pull off the track as well. No, not really, because you're on the way to set the track. It's for the marshals to get to. Man, we made it possible for me to run. Catch top 7, top 6 cars on time. Sight at the start of the round 3. So Grosjean, Ricardo, Bandor, Hamilton are all out, so Kvyat's driven an absolutely magical race here. He's just done everything right. Nearly a minute clear of third. A minute clear of third place. Only half a minute clear of second. Destroying this Grand Prix. The final ever Malaysian Grand Prix, technically, of course. In season 10. Never race a track again, never again. Anybody who hasn't followed me, guys, please be sure to drop me a follow. It really does help me out, of course. May as well start plugging the channel while I'm here on the YouTube. Click on the bubble right underneath the channel on Twitch. If you've done it at the time on YouTube, please drop me a subscription. It really helps. It really, really does. What people are doing. All the drive to 10,000 YouTube views. Okay, to the left here. Second stop go. He has given me a red wing. Well, this has got a bit more interesting, hasn't it? Okay. I don't want to want it, but we'll work on it. So we are now in trouble. Fit the wing, fit the wing, fit the wing, fit the wing. We now are on a chase down. Oh, you fucking idiot. Amazing, absolutely amazing. Parks on the apex. Words cannot explain. Right, okay, we don't have something to do there. This one has just been tall for us, so let's both us in it. Ten laps, this is gonna be absolutely fucking manic if I can pull this off. I've lost the race because of stupidity. Kvyat's parked, just parked on the apex again. No flashbacks, of course, so this is now us to the end. Three cars to overtake, and that is the absolute crash in front of me. What in the world are they doing? Completely and utterly mental. Palmer is just causing crash after crash after fucking crash, and now we've lost the race. Ecstasy to agony. Very, very good. Watch your errors. No, we have to fuck everyone else. We just can't just bother to know what we're doing here. That's not flying, it seems. It's just too many cars. It's kind of flies. Wow, that is Max Verstappen. Whoa, there's just this car. Go break, you fucking idiot. Bottas has just escaped. This is just embarrassing. VSC has actually killed me here. 13 seconds behind Bottas, all of a sudden. Lost the Grand Prix, which we should never have lost. Come on! Oh, for fuck's sake, come on, man! Bottas is just killing me. How has he managed to pull out a gap? Or he's not. Oh! Fucking joke. Okay. Well, there's another car going slow. I don't know what the fuck is happening in this Grand Prix. It's just all fell to shit at once. We have to put in 12 seconds in 9 laps now. And make a move on the last lap. We know what we have to do. No mystery to what we have to do here. Stroll's moved to 8th place thanks to Verstappen who's doing it. 9.4, we are catching Bottas. That is what we need to do. To be up to 8 seconds and become the start of the second set of the next lap. Otherwise we're not going to win this Grand Prix. We should have won this so easily at my racing track. Here we are. He's just going to get a punch in the face after this Grand Prix, I think. Fisticuffs will happen. Bottas. I believe that's Bottas there. Is he the next car? He's the next car. We have hope. Zero, it's looking good. Stroll Park's on the fucking apex this time. We need him to get out of the way rather quickly here. He's just parking on the fucking apex. Move! Opportunity to be put there. Not podium in a fucking McLaren, for fuck's sake. Oh, I've got 10 points in 3 years. I've got 15 points in one race. So we're now on the point of the season. Personal though, I am hunting down my third win of the Superbike Cup. Consistently so, I believe. Self and Valtteri, you can see it. Oh, that was Hamilton by the way, but he was on the podium with us. Going quicker and quicker. This is just one of the most unbelievable ends to a Grand Prix you're going to see in a career mode. Looks inevitable at the moment, but you never know what can happen. Perez. Perez is third! Perez is third! The equation complete. Forcing there on the march. This career mode. A huge step in the right direction. We can put that much points on Raikkonen. This may still change, but we'll move forward here. Come on. 4 laps here just to concentrate on building bridges. Putting the stanchion down on the bridge. We have got fastest laps and 2 consecutive laps and quickest wet lap ever. We just did 1:48 and never been done around Malaysia. Feel like a dangerous low. Fuck. I need to overtake him. 4 laps exactly. Running this race. Sergio Perez is running third. He's hit his part of the bargain. Can I do mine? 3 in a row, come on, 2 seconds. So it looks inevitable. But we've got to get past him as well, remember. You're putting all up. This is 4 fastest laps in 5 laps now. Come on. Absolutely flying. Attempts in that sector. Scruffy corner. Can't afford any. We're absolutely killing this Grand Prix right now. We need to win this. We've led that many laps. We had that much of a commanding lead. We're not getting screwed by Daniel Kvyat. And Kvyat is going to be there as well. Kvyat involved at the front battle. This is going to be amazing. Will we be able to do it? 2 hours of solid racing here. Let's come down. This. I love the tension. Bottas does have a quick enough car. I know the straights, but it's my cornering ability with this downforce and this beautiful, beautifully angling car. It's keeping me with it. If this was dry, DRS would be fucking in full flow at the moment. Ooh, it's now on the 4th fastest lap in a row. 5th and 6th laps. And 7 laps down Bottas. Here we go. It's going to set ourselves nicely. Penalty. I don't know how this game works in terms of glitches, so what we're going to do, we're going to motor. Not going to let off. Done it! Force India, 1-3. I thought that at the start of the stint. Two and a half laps to go, we've taken the lead again. They're commanding the race, 30 seconds at the road. Kvyat brake check. Oh, run wide. I've gone off the track. Fuck. Tesla's right back on me. Oh my god. Tension is real. Tension is fucking real here, folks. And everything. Just, oh, calm it down here. Come on, calm it down. So we got this guy's number. Sweat so much in a minute of my life. Right, can we do it? What's the question? Fuel's looking good. Comfortably in the lead. We're not. We're 32 seconds ahead. This one, if I get it, will be the best race win I've had on an F1 game. Is that everything, this Grand Prix? Original safety car. Bang on red flag halfway through the race. Catching Bottas, we had a McLaren and a Renault spinning towards me. And the gap with two laps ago is literally a second. Bottas doesn't deserve this. He's been really calm, but he doesn't deserve the win, in fairness. Only one man deserves that. I'm not biased. See it in this one. I want some 1-2s next year. Not comfortably pulling away from battle 3. But we're comfortably winning the race, it seems. Check something. Have to. Right, just a warning, wasn't it? Okay, it's just a stop-go. Vettel got a drive-through penalty. Which makes absolutely no difference to the race results. Kvyat is just in lap 55. Perez, you fucking beauty. Only us, Alonso, Hulkenberg, and Palmer have had 3 stops. Obviously, Verstappen did have them. Guys, this is what this career mode's going to be. I need to go get myself some warm welcome. So this is seriously something. Oh, lost our points, unfortunately. Please don't bin it. Unbelievable Grand Prix. I never thought I'd ever won like this. Isn't that everything? Retard Kvyat come back to strike back like he did in Britain in season 1. Stop their points in the wretched McLaren. I don't know what he's done it. Bottas amazing stuff, really. In this final lap. I served my penalty. Stayed out, really. It's still miles of the road, that's the point. Took the risk, pithy, got a wind change, drive through. Stop now, sorry. It's been a fucking mental Grand Prix. 5 retirements. As positively got wins. Yes. Come on. late. Oh my god. Do not do that to me again, F1. Oh, you're having too much of a comfortable race. Come on. 3 for the season. 3-5 with Force India.
A hard-fought win today, then, after a very difficult race.
Hard.
So, Ant, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
Well, I'd say it's just raw pace, plain and simple. I mean,
Perez,
you could sit here and talk about strategy all day, the overtaking, looking after the tyres, but at the end of it all, if you want to win, you need a package that's got the speed
that's
over everyone else,
confess.
And that's exactly what they had today.
Well, this is it. This is where they all want to
guys,
be. Here come the top three,
the
then,
three
out
with
onto
my
the podium after a fascinating Grand Prix.
8-4. Third race victory of the season. Third of a career. Two teammates. You get 40 points. You can look like about 20 at the start of the Grand Prix. Jesus.
So then, it's time to see how this result
Amazing.
Affects the Drivers' Championship. Well, the lead at the top has come down
Fine.
After a poor result for
Missed
our points,
points
leader.
By our
and
position.
Now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day? On to the constructors then. Ferrari,
oh.
extend
Who's
their
driver
lead
the day?
At
no
the
one.
Top of the championship. That's it for today's Grand Prix. And
yeah, I'm Vettel both tied for it, I guess.
Goodbye, and see you again next time.
An amazing Grand Prix, guys. Standings-wise, we're in 7th now. Verstappen pulling over. Ricardo, both Red Bulls retired actually in that Grand Prix. That's good. That's a good thing to note. And we are 102 points behind Sebastian Vettel. It's looking impossible to win this championship, especially with Suzuka coming up. But target here would be to beat Hamilton. We'll go for my teammate first. Constructors, we're going to be hauling people in. We are 84 points behind Ferraris. And a key thing. Only 51 behind, 49 behind Mercedes now. People have been destroyed. We are gunning for the championship next season. That, guys, is how you drive Malaysia. Without Kvyat there, of course. Oh, we're on all the scrolls now in bed. Fuck. Crying out loud. An amazing race. Not quite on the tyre wear program. Destroying Magnussen, this rivalry. Everybody's loving us at the moment. 11,000 again on the career mode score. And we are now hitting our pit stops much nicer. 10%, that's going to help us. No upgrades here, folks, for this one. I don't want to do an upgrade. I'm going to wait for the tyre. We're doing the tyre wear all the way to the end now. And then we're doing the aerodynamics. And then we're doing fuel. Then three major ones on aero. 4,500 points. We're going to hit that soon. So we're going to move on to the next Grand Prix now, which is Japan. I'm not doing that tonight. That is a killer. 2 hours and 5 minutes. 1 hour and 56 of that racing. Fucking hell. We are that good, of course. Guys, Japan will be tomorrow night. Just to confirm. Unless anything else comes up, you will be able to spot that on my Twitch Pulse, of course. If there's any reason I won't do it, I'll post it on there.
Hey, our upgrade pace is looking solid right now, but I do think we need to push hard.
I think the cars around me have improved.
Here's the report.
Yep, that makes total sense. Williams are catching us, Mercedes have improved greatly, of course. Moving on. Fucking hell. Mixed conditions, hopefully we don't have a wet race at Suzuka. I pray we don't have a wet race at Suzuka. We're going to be using this component. Third worst. Prax practice. This, yep, that one. Energy store. That will keep part 6 on. It's the third worst. But guys, that is positively bad. First of 100% race. I'm fucked. Please be sure to check out the other videos on my channel on YouTube. Click on the bubble writing in the Twitch description where it says YouTube. Click on that and subscribe if you can, please, guys. This has been Positively Glad. Take it easy. Much love. See me very soon for Suzuka. Goodbye for now.